Hello everyone. Yeah, so hello everyone and good evening. So welcome all of you for the Kahoot mega quiz for grade 4 and 5 of the National Astronomy Challenge participants. Yeah, I hope you all are excited to be a part of the quiz. Yeah, so first let me tell you, I'll be taking a moment to tell you a bit about today's quiz, that how exactly it is going to happen. And a few of the things that we want you to adhere to. Yeah. All right. First thing first. Today's quiz is for grade 4 and 5 students. Now, if you have been participating with us in the session, you might be knowing that, yes, we allow the students of the older age groups to participate in the quiz, in the different sessions. But this quiz is different. All right, so I would request all the students who are not from grade 4 and 5 to exit from today's quiz, to do not participate in the today's quiz. For you, we have another quiz scheduled tomorrow. All right, so please make sure that you do that. Otherwise, yeah, so that is one. Second thing, the platform, as you all know, for our quiz is Kahoot. Right. So I'll be showing you how exactly you can participate in the Kahoot. So I'll be showing you the questions and the options on my screen, and later on you can on the parallel screen you can participate in it. Right. So that was second thing. All right. So, and there is one very specific instruction I have on how you guys have to name yourself. All right. So please adhere to these. And I'll promise you that today's quiz will be very exciting and you all will enjoy it. Okay, so without any further delay, let's just get to it. Yeah. So here, I'll be sharing my screen though. I'll be sharing my screen to show you the quiz. Yeah. So basically, today's quiz is on the topic solar system, as you all have been intimated in. Yeah. So basically, it will be, so let me just begin it. So what is, I'll tell you a bit about the Kahoot platform first. So in the Kahoot platform, you all can play live together with me. All right. So for that, you need to get to your own Kahoot platform. How you will get that? I'll show you. So basically, to do that, you can do it two ways. You can either join us through the Kahoot website, www.kahoot.it, or with the Kahoot app. All right. So how exactly you will join us with the Kahoot website? There is this website, www.kahoot.it. On any of your device, even on the device on which you are seeing that session, if you want to do it on that, that would also fine. And otherwise, we would request you to get a second device, preferably a mobile phone. Then go to this website, www.kahoot.it. All right, once you go over there, it will ask you for your game pin. Yeah. You enter for your game pin and it will ask for your nickname. Now guys, remember, for our today's quiz, we do not want you to use your nickname. All the students should mention the names as registered with in the NAC. Okay, please put your complete registered name for the quiz so that we can see that who all are the participants, all the students who have joined. If you have not, basically, if you have not complied with it, make sure that you do it now. All right. So whoever this Lord Voldemort is, I am removing you from the quiz for now. You can join in again with your actual name. Okay. With your name and your surname. Everyone, please make sure that you join with the same name with which you have done it. Yeah. All right, so yeah, this is it. If there is anybody else like them, you guys can also make sure that you are only joining with your actual name. No nickname should be used for today's quiz. All right, so I'm waiting for students to join. As soon as all of you join, we will begin. So basically, I'll be waiting for 5 minutes to do that. Right now, the time is 5:35 IST. I'll be waiting for 5:40 IST and then we will move ahead. All right, so. So Genius Giraffe 3, whoever that is, please move out and join in with your actual name. All the students, I am requesting you once again, if you are using any nickname, please end the quiz and join in again with your actual name. All right. So yeah, I'm pointing out the ones which I can see over here. Others, you can please keep on finding out. Yeah. You all can see for yourself. Great. And all those who have joined later, I would request, repeat it once again that guys, this session is not like the other session where we welcome the students who are from the higher age groups as well. This particular quiz is for grade 4 and 5. So if you are above grade 4 and 5, we request you to please move out of the quiz. For you, we have another Kahoot planned tomorrow at the same time. All right, you should join in that one instead. Okay, so yeah, just to keep the fairity in here. So yeah. Okay, it is 36 now. I'm waiting for 4 more minutes and then we will begin. All right, so in the meantime, we are going ahead with it. I'll be telling you the format. So the format is like this. For each question, you will be getting from all the way from 20 seconds to 1 minute to answer. All right, so these questions can be options type in which you have to select one correct option out of 4. It can be true false, or it can be rearrange the options, right? It can be one of these 3 type of questions. So you have to answer those. The questions and the answer will appear on your screen. All right, so you can, while going with the quiz, you can basically move to that screen and basically go ahead with that only. But yes, after each question, I'll be explaining a bit about the correct answers. So in case you get any answer wrong, you can come back to my screen to see that how exactly, why exactly that question was wrong. Yeah. So there are a few more instructions. The first instruction is, all right, Nihal, again, you, I believe you missed the, you missed the instruction. So everyone, please note, I'm repeating it again. While entering your nickname, please enter the name exactly as you entered while registering for the NAC. Your registered name should be put over here. If you have put any other name, I would request you to please move out of the quiz and join back again with your actual name. Okay. Your Legend Horse 18. Again, you are also the same. You have also the same issue. Please move out from the quiz and join again with the name with which you have registered in the NAC. I'm removing you from it so you can join back again. I would request you to join back again with your actual name. Nihal, please join again with the name, with your actual name. Yeah, move out of the quiz now and join again with the name with which you have registered. Yeah, so I was telling you about the, yes, Decisive Pony. Once again, I will tell you once again, I have removed you from the quiz. Please join back again from with your actual name with which you have registered with, right? So Arctic Hamster, same thing. I'm removing you from the quiz. Please join back again with your actual name. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I removed something, someone else by mistake. Yes. So yeah, so everyone, all those who have removed, please make sure that you join back again with the name with which you have registered in the NAC. Yeah, so I'm waiting for 1 more minute for you to join. Everybody join in quickly. Yeah, and then we will begin. Polite Zebra, please join in with the name with which you have registered in the NAC. I'm waiting for you. Yeah, I have removed you from the quiz. I'm waiting for you to join back again with your actual name here. Okay, great. 205 participants here we have. All right, I'm waiting for 1 more minute for the new participants who have asked you to rejoin. Again, Aquatic Bunny, same thing. Please join in with your actual name. Don't use the nickname over here. Yeah. All right. So 206, 7 participants we have. I believe we are ready to begin in a minute. Aquatic Bunny, I'll be removing you now. Please join back again with your actual name. Yeah. Guys, I've been repeating this instruction again and again. When you are joining here, please join in with the name with which you have registered in the NEC. No other name will be entertained. Yes, so again, you all can see your name once you have joined over here. All right, so I believe most of us are here. Yes, so the participation have stopped now. I think we are ready to begin. I'll be starting in the next 30 seconds. So if you haven't joined till now, please join in the next 30 seconds. In 30 seconds, we are going to begin our quiz. All those who are waiting, please wait patiently. We are going to begin in the next 30 seconds. So yes, you will be seeing the questions and the answer in the screen. And after each question, I'll be telling you the right answer and the reason why it is right. All right. Now, apart from that, second thing here, you will get extra point for maintaining a streak. So make sure that you maintain the streak of the correct answers. So with this, 10 more seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and now. So here we are starting off the Mega Kahoot quiz. It has 20 questions. And the first question for our quiz is this. About dash percent of Earth's surface is covered with water. Is it red option 20%, blue option 80%, yellow option 67%, or green option 71%? How much percent of Earth's surface is covered with water? Very good. So yes, like you all saw that, you got 20 seconds to answer this question. Yeah. So the correct answer was given by 153 students. Let's see how you guys fared and who get to be on the top. So yes, so the top five positions are taken by Ayan, Disha, Rashmi, Vivan Goyal, and Ekanch. Very well done, everyone. Others, I believe you are not very far behind. It is only the first questions. We have 20 questions here. Let's buckle up. And with this, let's get to the second question. I hope you all have understood what you have to do. And with this, let's get to the second question. And the second question for our today's quiz is this. The belt of rocks between the orbit of Mars and Jupiter is called red option, asteroid belt, blue option, orbital belt, yellow option, rock belt, or green option, comet belt. What is this belt of rock between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter known as? Come on, come on, one more seconds. And 203 of you were able to answer, and most of you again gave the correct answer. Yes, it is called asteroid belt. So basically, there is an entire belt of rocks where there are millions of rocks scattered around. So these rocks can span around various, let's say, thickness. The largest of them is as wide as 900 kilometers in diameter, and the smallest can be as small as a pebble. So yeah, so these are the kind of rocks which are scattered around here, and these rocks are called asteroid. And the belt that I'm referring to is called asteroid belt, as 777 of you have given answered correctly. Let's take a look at the scoreboard. So the scoreboard looks like this, and it has completely changed. I'm loving it. So now on the first position, we have Disha, followed by Rashmi, Garv, Rushank, and Om Hanumante. Very well done, everyone. You guys are performing absolutely amazingly. Let's get to the next question. And up to 41 places, Monisha Kapalla is the highest climber. Way to go, Monisha. Let's get to the next question, everyone. I hope you are excited for it, yeah? And the next question starts in... Okay, so here's the next question. Object E in the solar system diagram represented in the object is this. So guys, here is the diagram. Look at the diagram and identify what is on object E. If you are unable to see on your screen, please come to my screen to see it. Here is the object E. I'm marking it. Name this object. What is it? Which planet is this object E? Come on, come on. Very good. Yes. All right. So this was a tough question. Almost around 40% of you gave the answer wrong. So I'll just tell you, here we are talking about object E, right? So if you look very closely, object A here is Sun, B would be Mercury, C would be Venus, D would be Earth, and E would be the planet Mars, right? So very well done to those who answered it correctly. The correct answer was Mars, but 82 of you confused it with Earth. No worries, it was a bit of a tough question. Let's take a look how it changed the scoreboard. And as expected, it changed the scoreboard again completely. And now we have Rushank Pawar on the first position, followed by Rayan. Then we have Om Hanumante, Nandini L. Patil, and Swaraj. Very well done, guys. And up to 61 places, Manasvi Pathak is the highest climber. Way to go, Manasvi. Keep it up. And with that, let's get to the next question, everybody. The next question, question number four, is this. The name of the largest moon of Saturn is? What is the name of the largest moon of Saturn? Is it red option, Enceladus? Blue option, Europa? Yellow option, Titan? Or green option, Triton? Name of the largest moon of Saturn. Very well. Okay. Yes, the name is Titan. Now, Enceladus is also a moon of Saturn, but it is not the largest one. Largest one is the Titan. And the Europa, which you many of you have answered, it is actually the moon of Jupiter, whereas Triton is the moon of Neptune. Now, there is one very interesting fact about Titan. It is that you know, there we have discovered that Titan has the atmosphere and it also has the methane lakes on its surface. So it is one of the hidden worlds on which scientists and astronomers are expecting that there may be life present on it. Right now, we are not advanced enough to search for that life, obviously. But yes, it is a very exciting place to go. I mean, in future. Yeah. So yeah. So with this, let's look at the scoreboard. And the scoreboard have changed once again. And now the first position is taken by Nandini L. Patil, followed by Om Hanumante. Then we have Arjun Kedar Bagh, Swaraj, and Amey Kapoor. Combo breaker. 19 players just dropped their answer streak of 3. All right. I hope it was not that much of a tough question. Yeah. But let's see. Let's see. All those who dropped your answer streak, don't worry, guys. You still have the chance to basically come back. Question number 5. Which of these planets has invisible rings? Is it the Saturn? Is it the Venus? Is it Uranus? Or is it Mars? Come on, 8 more seconds. Answer everyone very quickly. Which of these planets has invisible rings? Is it Saturn, Venus, Uranus, or Mars? Yes, it is the Uranus. Most of you again answered correctly. Very well done, guys. You see, the thing is, I'll tell you that Saturn rings are made up of rocks and ice particles, and that's why it is very prominently visible to us. But Uranus, even though it also has a rings, the rings are very faint. And most of the time, they're not even visible in the visible range. You actually have to get into the infrared region to see them properly. Yes, so that's why we say that it has the rings, but it is invisible. So yeah, so kudos to the 169 who got it correct. And all those who got it wrong, don't worry, at least now you know the answer. Yeah. So with this, let's look at the scoreboard. And the scoreboard looks like this. Here, Nandini L. Patil maintained her position for the first time in the quiz. Someone maintained the position. Very well done. And she's now followed by Swaraj, Amey Kapoor, Ekansh, and Siddharth. Very well done, guys. And 14 players have reached the answer streak of 4. Great job, everybody. Let's get to the next question after this. I hope you are maintaining your excitement. Yeah, question number 6, worth double points. All right. The light from the sun reaches Earth in 30 minutes, 15 minutes, 6 minutes, 40 seconds, or 8 minutes, 20 seconds. How much time does it take for the light to reach Earth from sun? Everybody answer quickly. 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes, very well done. 169 of you knew this. So yes, The actual answer is 8 minutes and 20 seconds. It is actually sunlight takes 8 minutes and 20 seconds to reach Earth. And that's the reason that we always see the sun bit in the past. Yeah, so that's correct. Well, let's say nothing to more to explain over here. And let's see after this question, who get to be on the scoreboard. And it is surprising now. For the first time, all five of the players maintained the answer streak and maintained their position. Very well done, guys. Now, another thing. Everyone, please note that double point questions are actually the very interesting ones. Why? Because these are the questions which have double rewards. And let's say what we say, if you get it wrong, you actually go down double points. So yeah, so it is these are the very interesting questions. So make sure that you answer these questions with patience. Yeah. Let's get to the next question. Question number 7. How many days does Earth take to complete one revolution around the sun? I hope you all know what is a revolution, right? How many days does Earth take to complete one revolution? Is it 365 days? Is it 300 days? Is it 244 days? Or is it 347 days? Come on, come on, everyone. 3 more seconds. 2, 1, and 0. Wow. 223 of you gave it correctly. Yes, it was a very easy question, right? So all those who missed it, no worries. But remember that revolution is actually completed in 365 days. And that is the reason that we have 1 year of 365 days. It happens because it happens when basically Earth revolves once around the sun. Yeah. So correct answer was this. And most of you gave it correctly. Let's see who get to be on the podium after this. And is there any changes? Yes, there are. And Amay have climbed up, followed by Swaraj and Ekansh and Siddharth. And Nandini maintained their position, and 3 in a row. Lakhit is back in the game. Very well done, Lakhit. Let's get to the next question, everyone. Question number 8. Worth double points once again. Be careful, guys. Which of the following planet is closest to Earth? Let's see who answers that correctly. Which of the following planet is closest to Earth? Is it red option Mercury, blue option the Moon, yellow option Venus, or green option Mars? Remember, which of the following planets is closest to Earth? Aha, it was a trick question, and 16 of you got in the trick. So basically, I didn't ask the closest body to the Earth, I asked the closest planet. So Moon is not the answer anymore, right? But the correct answer is Venus. It is actually Venus, which is closest to Earth, and the second closest is actually the Mars. So Venus is called the sister planet of Earth for two reasons here, because it is very close. And second, they are almost of the same size. Yeah. So the Venus was the correct answer. Majority of you though got it correct, but 65 who said Mars, you are also pretty close. These are the kind of facts which you not normally know, right? So it's okay. It's absolutely fine in case you didn't know this earlier, but I hope you know this now. Yeah. And that is amazing. So yeah, with this, let's take a look at the scoreboard. And the scoreboard, yes, it has changed. And now Swaraj is on top, followed by Siddharth. Then we have Arjun, Arushi, and Om Hanumante. So very well done, guys. And Rayansh Sameer is making a comeback with 3 in a row. Very well done, Rayansh. Keep it up. Let's get to the next question, guys. I hope you guys are ready. Question number 9, true, false. Saturn has the highest number of moons in our solar system. Is this statement true or is this false? Saturn has the highest number of moons in our solar system. Yes, come on, answer it very quickly. 5 more seconds. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, it was almost like 60-40, yeah? So the correct answer is true. Now, all those who said false, you might be basically thinking that it is Jupiter. Yes, it was Jupiter until recently, that Jupiter was the planet with the highest number of moons. But 2 years before now, we actually discovered some more moons of Saturn. And right now, Saturn is the planet which have highest number of moons. So Saturn's moons now count to 82, right? So that is the reason that it has overtaken Jupiter, and here it is the planet with the highest number of moons. And yes, 125 of you who says true are correct. Let's take a look at the scoreboard after this, and the scoreboard looks like this now. So we have Siddharth, Arjun, Kedar Vag, Arushi Sahai, Arav Kurup, and Sambhav in the top five. Very well done. And nine players just hit the answer streak of six. Very well done, guys. You are playing absolutely amazingly. Yeah. All right. So with that, let's get to the halfway, the 10th question. And the 10th question for our today's quiz is this. Which of the following is the smallest planet in the solar system? Which one is the smallest planet in the solar system? Is it Pluto? Is it Mercury? Is it Mars? Or is it Venus? Which of the following is the smallest planet in the solar system? Come on. Come on, everyone. Yes, majority again gave it correctly, and the correct answer is Mercury. All those who says Pluto, I also basically sympathize with you. Why? Because even I am sad that Pluto is no longer a planet. But I hope you guys missed that, yeah? Pluto was the smallest planet until it was a planet. But if you guys remember, a decade before now, we actually removed Pluto from the designation of the planet. And that's why we no longer consider it a planet even. How can it be the smallest one? Yeah? So that's the reason that you guys are not correct. So yeah, so again, apart from that, yes, 187 of you are correct. And that's how basically it is. And let's take a look at the scoreboard. And the scoreboard looks like this now. Here we have Arushi getting to the top now, followed by Arjun, Arav, Sambhav, and Ayushman Nayak. Very well done. Shaurya Mohit has the highest answer streak of 10. All right, great job, Shaurya. And you can see the competition we have right now, that Shaurya, despite having the highest on streak, could not even break into the top five. Yeah. So no worries, Shaurya. Keep it up. Let's see if I get to see your name in the top five. Others also, come on, keep it up. Let's get to, okay. So here we are at the halfway mark. So I hope you have been enjoying the quiz till now. Yeah. Can you keep it up? Let's see. If you guys can keep it up, look, here we are on the 11th question. It is a puzzle question, actually. Arrange this planet from the largest to the smallest. So guys, I rearrange it this way that the first one, you put it, the one which you think is the largest. After that, the second largest, third largest, and the smallest. And once you rearrange all of them, no, then press on K. Remember, your answers won't be submitted until you press on K. All right. So come on. You still have around 30 seconds for this question. So rearrange them and submit your answers. Come on top should be the one which is the largest in size. Second number, the second largest, then third largest, then the smallest. Come on. 16 more seconds, everyone. Do it quickly. 10 more seconds. Yes. Submit it now. Everyone, please submit it. Yeah. And here. Yes. All right. 58 of you could not get it correctly. You see, here is the thing. The largest one is Jupiter, which you should have put on the front. The first. The second is Saturn. After that, we have the Earth, and Mars is actually smaller than Earth. Yes. So maybe many of you made mistakes in this. So Earth is actually a bit larger than Mars, and Mars is somewhat around 0.7 times as large as Earth. Yeah. So you can think of it this way that, okay, so if the Earth is, let's say, around 1 meter over here, so it will be around 70 centimeter, the Mars, right? So it is somewhat around that. Yeah. So the Mars is actually smaller than Earth. So 42% of you gave it correctly. It was a tough question, wasn't it? Let's take a look at the scoreboard now. So the scoreboard has changed, and Arjun has broken into the top five, is on top now, followed by Arush, Arav, Ayushman, and Monisha. Very well done, Monisha. Okay. guys, and three in a row, Akshara Reddy is back in the game. Okay, great job, everyone. Let's get to the next question. Yeah, I hope you guys are still excited. Here, the next question for our today's quiz, question number 12, is this. The name of the largest asteroid in the asteroid belt is called? What is the name of the largest asteroid in the asteroid belt? Remember, I told you that there is a belt of rocks between Mars and Jupiter. What is the largest one on those? Is it Ganymede? Is it Ceres? Is it Vesta? Or is it Pallas? The largest asteroid. Yes, the name of the largest asteroid is Ceres, right? So basically, guys, Ganymede, it actually, even though it is bigger than Ceres, it does not lie in the asteroid belt. So that's why Ganymede as an answer is taken off. And then Vesta and Pallas, even though they are also very large asteroid, they are not as large as the Ceres. So Ceres is quite large. Remember, I told you that they can have a size as big as 900 kilometers in diameter. That is the diameter of Ceres. And because it is so big, we even consider Ceres as a dwarf planet, which is basically a smaller planet, right? So actually, for Pluto also, we have designated it to a dwarf planet only. Yeah. So here, with that, let's take a look at the scoreboard. And the scoreboard have changed a bit now, and Arav has overtaken Arush. Great job, guys. Three players hit the answer streak of 7. And with that, let's take a look at the next question. Question number 13. Which of the following is the largest moon in our solar system? Now tell me the largest moon in our solar system. Is it Ganymede? Is it Phobos? Is it Europa? Or is it Titan? Yeah, come on. Come on, come on. 5 more seconds. Answer it quickly, everybody. Yes, is it Ganymede, Phobos, Europa, or Titan? Yes, it is Ganymede. Very well done. All those students who were saying basically it is the largest asteroid, no, Ganymede was the largest moon. Ganymede, the moon of Jupiter, is the largest moon of all the other moons in our solar system. Titan, even though it is very large, it is not as big as Ganymede. Titan is the largest moon of Saturn. But Ganymede is the largest moon in the entire solar system. All right, so that is the difference. I hope now you guys know it, right? Phobos here is the largest moon of Mars, wherein Mars have 2 moons, right? Phobos and Deimos. The larger one is Phobos, and Europa is also the moon of Jupiter, but it is not as big as Ganymede. Yeah, let's take a look at the scoreboard now. So the scoreboard has completely changed. All right, it has. So many people have moved up. And so we have Arav, Arjun, Ayushman, Monisha, and Nabroon Kashyap entered into the top 5. Very well done, Nabroon. And Ahan is making a comeback with 3 in a row. Very well done, Kahan. Keep it up. Let's get to the next question. Question number 14. Which of the following planets appears brightest from the Earth? Let's see who answers this. Appears brightest from the Earth. Which planet appears brightest in the night sky? Is it Jupiter? Is it Venus? Is it Saturn? Or is it Mars? Which planet appears brightest? Very well done. Most of you knew this. It is the Venus, our morning and evening star, what we call it, right? So it is basically, it is the, as soon as the sunset, you will see either it rising after sunset or before sunrise. Yeah, so it is there along with the sun. And yes, it is the brightest of them all. Yeah, and very interesting fact, Venus is actually the second brightest object of the entire night sky. Brightest object of the night sky is moon. Second brightest is Venus only. If you take out the moon, nothing in the sky is as bright as this planet. Yeah, so that is it. 189 of you got it correct. Very well done, guys. Let's take a look at the scoreboard. And top 5, nobody is ready to compromise their positions now. But I can see that they are still very close. For example, Ayushman and Monisha, only 2 point difference. Yeah. So let's keep it up, everybody. Here, 4 players have reached the answer streak of 6. Let's see, guys, if you can break into the top 5. Don't lose hope. Try harder. The faster you answer, the more chance you have to get into the top 5. All right, let's get to the 15th question now. The first man to step on the moon was it Yuri Gagarin? Was it Buzz Aldrin? Was it Neil Armstrong? Or was it Michael Collins? The first man to step on the moon was, come on, you all should know it. Was it Yuri Gagarin? Was it Buzz Aldrin? Was it Neil Armstrong? Or was it Michael Collins? Yes, he was Neil Armstrong. Yuri Gagarin was the first man in space. He just went beyond the atmosphere and returned back. Yes, whereas Buzz Aldrin and Michael Collins was the part of the team who went to the moon along with Neil Armstrong. But the person to step on the moon first was Neil Armstrong. Yeah, so all of us should know that, right? So here, very well done, all 233 of you who got it correct. Let's see who answered it first and who get to be in the top five. And here, Monisha answered it very quickly. Very well done, Monisha. So here, three in a row. Vyom Dev Aaron is back in the game. Very well done, Vyom Dev. Keep it up. Let's get to the next question. Question number 16 now. Double points. All right. Again, guys, you have a chance. Which of the following is a Jovian planet? What is a Jovian planet? Let's see who all knows which one of the following is a Jovian planet. Is it Venus? Is it Saturn? Is it Earth? Or is it Mars? The Jovian planet. Yeah. Very well done. 170 of you gave the correct answer saying, all right. So yeah, so the Jovian planet is Saturn. So Saturn, basically, I'll just tell you all those who do not, who gave it wrongly, I'll just tell you that what exactly is a Jovian. So if you see in a solar system, there are two types of planets you will see. The one which have a solid surface to stand on. These planets are Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. They have a solid surface, right? We are standing on a surface. Similarly, Mercury, Venus, and Earth also have a solid surface. And that's why they are called terrestrial planets, right? Whereas the outer planets, we call them gas giants. Why? Because they're so big that they're entirely made up of gases. So all these planets, which you see over here, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, all of them, they actually are completely made up of gases and they do not have a solid surface. So we call them gas giants. And another word for gas giants is Jovian. All right. That's the reason we call them Jovian planets. So out of these four, only Saturn was a Jovian. And 770 of you got it correct. Very well done. And here, Ayushman have overtaken Arjun. And Manthan is making a comeback with three in a row. Well done, Manthan. You still have some time to catch up. Let's see the 17th question. Which is the hottest planet in the solar system? Let's see who got it correct. Is it Mars? Is it Venus? Is it Jupiter? Or is it Mercury? The hottest planet in the solar system. Is it Mars, Venus, Jupiter, or Mercury? Yeah, come on, answer quickly. Yes, it is Venus. Yeah, so Mars is actually quite cold, you know. In the average temperature on Mars, it is as low as minus 60 degrees Celsius. So average temperature is even in minus. So it is not even on the contender to be the hottest. But the two planets which were Venus and Mercury, right? Mercury itself is very hot. The reason for it is actually very close to the sun and it gets very hot, right? And this is the reason that it does not even have an atmosphere. But for Venus is the hottest because it has a lot of what we call the greenhouse gas. They trap in the heat so much that most of the, even the surface of Venus is molten. It's so hot, right? So average temperature on Venus can rise up to 250 to 300 degrees Celsius. So that's hot, right? And that's the reason that Venus is the hottest. And 181 of you got it correct. Very well done. Let's take a look at the scoreboard. And the scoreboard looks like this. And top five maintained their position. Very well done. And up to 12 places, Aaron Jatwani is the highest climber. Very well done. With that, we are here to the 18th question. Here, the 18th question of our today's quiz is this. Which of the following planets does not have an atmosphere? Okay. Is it Mars? Is it Venus? Is it Mercury? Or is it Uranus? Yeah. If you guys are paying attention, I already told you the answer to this one. Let's see who all remember it. Okay. It was Mercury. Guys, you should pay attention. I was giving you a hint at the end of the last question while explaining. Just now I told you that Mercury is so close to the sun that it does not even have an atmosphere, right? All the other planets, Mars, Venus, Uranus itself is made entirely of gases. So if you want to see Uranus, it is all atmosphere, nothing else, right? So it has an atmosphere. Even Venus has an atmosphere, which makes it very hot. Mars is an atmosphere. The atmosphere of Mars is very quite scarce, but still there. But Mercury, it has nothing, right? It is as barren as Earth, right? And this is because it is very close to the sun. And 147 of you got it correct. Let's take a look at the scoreboard. And Arjun and Ishan have climbed up into the places. And Ishan is the new entrant in the top five. Welcome, Ishan. And 19 players have reached the answer streak of 7. Very well done, everybody. Let's get to the next question. Question number 19. The axis of Earth is tilted by how many degrees? Is it 25 degrees? Is it 23.5 degrees? Is it 66.5 degrees? Or is it 12 degrees? The axis of Earth, remember Earth has an axis from North Pole to South Pole. How many degrees it is tilted? It was 23.5 degrees and 168 of you got it correct. Don't worry, guys, if you got it wrong, you should know the correct answer now. It is tilted 23 and a half degrees. And you know, the beautiful thing on Earth, that is the seasons on Earth, the spring, the summer, the winter, the autumn, they all are the result of this one. If our Earth axis was not tilted, we would never have seasons. Yeah, so it is tilted by 23 and a half degrees. Not 25, not 12, not 66.5, it is 23. I hope you guys remember it because sometimes in the question in GK also, they ask you this question. Yeah, so you should remember this. So let's take a look at the scoreboard. And here, Monisha have top now. All right, Monisha is on top, followed by Arjun, Ayushman, Arav, and Akshaj. All right, guys, nice. Shlok Joshi is back with the answer streak of 3. Very well done, Shlok. Let's see if you can pop him into the top 5. And with this, guys, buckle up. There are only 2 questions, only the last question now, I think. Let's see who get to the final question. Okay, who gets to top after this? Question is true or false? Venus has only 1 moon. What do you think of this statement? Venus has only 1 moon. Is this statement true or is this false? Come on, answer quickly. What do you think of this statement? Is it true or is it false? Yes, it is false. Why false? Because in our solar system, there are 2 planets. This do not even have a moon. First one is the Mercury and second one is Venus. So Venus actually does not have even a single moon. So this statement which says Venus has only 1 moon is false. So let's take a look at the scoreboard one final time. The podium of our today's quiz is this. Third position, we have Ayushman. Very well done, Ayushman. Congratulations. And second, we have Arjun Kedar Wagh. Very well done. And the spotlight today, we have Monisha. Very well done, Monisha, and kudos to the runners up Arav and Akshaj. Very well done, guys. You all played amazingly well, and you can see that all 3 did not get a single answer. Yeah, so that was our today's quiz. And let me share a fact: practice makes perfect. 40% of all the answers given were correct. These are the difficult questions. 11, 16, 8, and 19, and 17. I hope I was able to give you the correct answers for all of them and explain it to you. And with this, our today's quiz comes to an end. Before I let you go, few things. Number one, this quiz has nothing to do with the NEC exams. Everyone, please remember that these quizzes do not have to do anything with the exam. It's not that the question have come up. They may come in the NAC. We can never say that they won't come, but it is no direct relation. Okay. So you should not think it this way. That is one. All right. Second, it is only for fun. Yeah. So make sure if you performed very well, if you are on the podium, well and good. You perform wonderfully well. But if you do not get onto the podium or even could not get many answers correct, don't get disheartened. It is a process of learning, right? How will we learn if you don't give the wrong answers? Yeah. So keep on learning, keep on practicing. And this way, maybe next time you get on the podium. So with this, I'll tell you that we have many different engagements planned for October, which will be visible to you from 1st onwards. Yeah. So keep an eye on that. We have very interesting sessions for the next month. And with that, we will see you again in the next engagement. Till then, stay curious, keep learning. You all have your learning material ready with you. Yeah. Keep on learning it. Keep on going through it. It has some very nice facts. Yeah. And that was all from our end. So let me check if there is anything else now. Yeah. All right. So yeah. So this was all, guys. And with this, I would like to take a leave from our today's session. And until next time, thank you so much. Yeah. Bye-bye.